Well, a group of Silicon Valley engineers is trying to outshine one of nature's most coveted objects.
They're among a handful of companies growing diamonds in a lab. CBS News' John Blackstone has the story.
At this Silicon Valley startup, engineers are doing in weeks what takes nature millions of years.
Just like out of mine, our growth chambers produce a rough diamond.
They're making diamonds. Jeremy Scholes, chief technology officer of the Diamond Foundry, carefully shows off some of what they create.
For us, in just a few weeks, we produce a one-carat stone with plasma and with chemistry. We're accelerating the very same processes that happen in the Earth.
To protect their secrets from the competition, the Diamond Foundry provided only glimpses of the machines that at 10,000 degrees Fahrenheit rearrange carbon atoms into precious gems.
To the layperson, it would be very hard to see some of the differences.
John King is chief quality officer of the Gemological Institute of America. He grades diamonds and says there's little difference between those mined from the earth and those grown in a machine.
They're both diamonds. They have the same chemical properties, the same physical properties.
A diamond is forever.
The world's leading diamond producer, De Beers, told CBS this morning the finite nature of natural diamonds makes them inherently valuable. Synthetic diamonds can be mass-produced and will not retain value over time. But whether diamonds are coming from the earth or from Silicon Valley, don't expect a bargain. Foundry diamonds cost only about 15% less. John Blackstone, CBS News, San Francisco.